Hello everyone and welcome back to another Microsoft Excel short tutorial. In this video, I will show you a few examples of using conditional formatting and how it can help you to easily highlight cells with specific fill and font colors for easy identification. Let's begin, and here I have this suggested video's views data of my YouTube channel listing around 500 rows. Here I want to highlight cells with a specific color according to the text they contain. For instance, I want to highlight all those cells containing the text value, how to add joint picture, under the source title column. There are too many cells that contain the same text value and I want to highlight them all at once with a specific color. So, I will start by selecting column C for source title and then clicking the conditional formatting drop-down menu from the Home tab. There are certain highlight cell rules available that you can apply, like highlighting the cells having specific greater, smaller, between, or equals numerical values that you can assign. You can also highlight cells according to dates or duplicate values. For this tutorial, we will first go with the text that contains rules. Under the format cells that contain the text box, you can provide the value for which you want to highlight the cells with a specific color. You don't need to type the complete text, instead you can type a part of the text that you want to investigate and highlight. For instance, we want to highlight all the cells which contain the text, how to add join picture. We don't even need to type the complete text, and the contained text value means that the value could be anywhere in the beginning, middle, or in the end of the source title. Then you need to choose that which fill and text color you want to use to highlight all those cells which contain that specified text value. Let's say I choose light red fill with dark red text. In the background, you can see that Excel has already highlighted those cells containing the text value we specified. So, we have applied a single condition to highlight cells having a specific text value, but if you want, then you can also add more than one condition. Like, I also want to add another condition to highlight those cells who are having the text value which contains best Y normal photo. While selecting the entire source title column, which is column C for this worksheet, I will again move to conditional formatting, highlight cells rules, text that contains, and this time I will type best Y normal photo, and will highlight them with green fill with dark green text. Hit the OK and we have all the cells highlighted having two different text rules. Later, if you want to see or modify the rules, then you can go to conditional formatting and then click manage rules. Here you can see all the rules defined to the selected cells or entire column. You can create new rules, edit previously created rules, delete them, or can also make duplicate rules and change their cell ranges. Keep in mind that you can also apply different conditional formatting rules for each column. Like, if I also want to highlight those cells having a numerical value between 50 to 100 for column D, then I can simply select that column, move to conditional formatting, highlight cells rules, and choose between this time. Here I will define the values under format cells that are between 50 and 100 and will then highlight them with a specific fill and font color that I want. So, you can use different conditional formatting rules for different columns and can highlight cells with the desired fill and font colors to easily identify them. Besides highlight cells rules, you can also use some predefined top-bottom rules. Like, if I want to highlight the top 10 items from watch time, hours, from column E, then I can easily do that by selecting the column first and then going to conditional formatting, top, bottom rules, and then clicking on top 10 items. Here you can specify that how many cells that you want to highlight according to their top rank. These types of rules are mostly defined for numerical values. You can increase or decrease the number of cells that you want to highlight and choose a specific fill and font color. Hit the OK key and there you have all the top ranking cells get highlighted for you in a second. Microsoft Excel will automatically choose and highlight top ranking cells according to their highest value from the selected cells or column. In the same way, you can also choose bottom 10 items, above average, or below average rules, and Excel will automatically do the math for you and will highlight those cells. You can also apply predefined data bars, color scales, and icon sets to the selected cells. Excel will then automatically count the total numbers of values and will then highlight the cells with different data bars, color scales or icon sets according to their cell values. Like if you choose icon sets of 4 different colors, then Excel will count the total numbers of selected cells and will divide them into 4 segments, each having a different icon set color according to their values. You can also apply data bars, color scales, and icon set rules together on the selected cells. Later, you can clear the rules either from the selected cells or from the entire worksheet at once from the Conditional Formatting's Clear Rules section. Clearing rules is just like deleting rules through the Manage Rules window, and from this window you can also delete rules from the selection, entire worksheet, or from a specific worksheet of the workbook. You can easily highlight those cells from the selected range having a duplicate value. Select the entire column or range of cells and then go to Highlight Cells Rules and click Duplicate Values. Here you can specify either you want to apply a color to the duplicate values, or you can apply color to all the unique values as well. You can also specify your own colors through the Custom Format window. If you choose New Rule from the Conditional Formatting drop-down menu, then you are presented with a window from where you can first choose a rule type. According to the rule type that you will choose, the below Edit the Rule Description will change according to the rule type you will choose from the top. So I hope you will find this tutorial useful.